Now let's do a quick music demo. We're going to put in one instrument and one vocal here. So you double click over here to put your first track in. And now let's name this, which you're going to want to do, believe me, especially when you get lots of tracks in here. It can get confusing. So just double click in that little window and let's call this one piano. Okay, now I'm using virtual instruments here. I have an article on that on Homebrew Audio. It's also in the Newbie's Guide to Audio Recording Awesomeness Reaper course. And the piano is going to be controlled by something called MIDI, M-I-D-I. And yes, there's another article about that on Homebrew Audio. There's also another video here on YouTube for that. And of course, it is in the Newbie's Guide to Audio Recording Awesomeness Reaper course. So the first thing I'm going to want to do is arm this track for recording. And now you see that it's set up to record the microphone like before. But we don't want that. We want it to record the MIDI keyboard. I have a MIDI keyboard hooked up to my sound card. So we are going to click on this drop-down menu, this input menu right here, and we're going to choose Input MIDI. And if you have a MIDI keyboard set up, it will show that here. If you don't, you can still use the virtual MIDI keyboard, which is built into Reaper. And then you can use your computer keyboard. I am going to use my micro control. Now you see that as I speak, this little meter readout goes away, which means it's not recording the mic anymore. But if I tap on my MIDI keyboard, you can see that it's receiving MIDI data. That's that little red line that's going up and down there every time I tap on my keyboard. But it's not making any noise. That's because there's no instrument attached. We named it piano, so you probably have a clue what kind of instrument we're going to attach. To do this, just come up to the FX button and click on VSTi. Reaper comes with some of these built in, the Resynth, Resynth DR, and Resamplomatic. I'm going to use this Forefront Piano module. You can actually download this for free on the web, just do a search. There's also a video on the Homebrew Audio YouTube channel that shows you how to install this. Anyway, let's go ahead and click that. I double click it. Now at this point, you can see that the Forefront Piano is attached, so just go ahead and click the X. Now, if you tap the keyboard, you notice you still can't hear it. This can cause great frustration. That's because you're not monitoring the input. So come here to this little button where it says In. Click on this until it turns green, and then you will be monitoring your input. Now, when you tap on the keyboard, you can hear the piano. If you want the music to be a certain tempo, which I highly recommend, come up here to this little icon of a metronome and click on that, and that will turn it on. And just hit the space bar to play, and you can hear the tempo. So you can tell that's in 4/4, and it gives you a click track of the tempo. If you want to change that or check what it is, come over to the Project Settings icon, and you can see that it's set to 120 beats per minute. And the time signature is 4/4. You can change both of those things to suit the beat of your music. Okay, now we're going to record some piano. So let's do a count in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So we hit the record button. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So these are MIDI notes, M-I-D-I, and now you have a music track. So let's come back over to the record button, the record arm button, and turn that off. And we're going to add a track so that we can add a vocal. This will show you how you can record your songs in Reaper. So let's just double click to add a track, and let's write vocal in here. And if you want to sing along to your music, or you want to record someone else singing along to your music, you just arm this track to record and put some headphones on at this point and turn off your speakers. The reason that we record the voice on a separate track, which is called overdubbing, is so that the voice will be all by itself in the track and the piano will be all by itself. And that way you can adjust the relative volumes of each against each other. You can mix them together. You can't do that if the sound of the piano is playing while you're singing and it all gets picked up by the microphone, because then the vocal track will have both vocal and the sound of the piano from the speakers in it. So, arm the vocal track to record and hit the record button. This is some singing just to show you how to record. And click the stop button, save all. Turn off the record arm button. Okay, let's listen to how that sounds. This is some singing just to show you how to record. Okay, that doesn't sound bad. The piano might be a little loud, so you can just come over here to the volume on the piano track and turn that down. This is some singing just to show you how to record. Okay, that's a rough mix of the volumes. Now let's add some effects to the vocal. So come over to the FX button and go to Kakos, that's the name of the parent company for Reaper, and that will bring in all of the effects that come with Reaper. I'm going to choose Reverberate to put a little reverb on the voice. I'm going to come up to the presets here, little drop-down menu, and I'm going to choose Live Vocal. Now, if you hit the space bar, that's like hitting the play button. Go ahead and hit the space bar and see what that sounds like. This is some singing just to show you how to record. That's not bad. If that's a little too much reverb for you, you can turn down the wet here and it'll be more subtle. This is some singing just to show you how to record. And you can also play with these other presets, or you can mess with these and create your own. So just click on the X. Okay, so once you're happy with the mix and the sound of the effects and everything, then let's just do like we did before. Go to File and go to Render and change the name to something you like. I'll just say Piano and Voice and click Render One File. Now, if you want to hear what that one audio file sounds like that you just created, let's go ahead and mute those two. Let's create a new track. Come back to the beginning. Go to Insert, Media File, and find the file that you just rendered. Double click on it and it imports it right into Reaper, and that's what it looks like. This is just one file playing now. This is some singing just to show you how to record. Of course, you can add as many voices and instruments as you want to, and then mix it down to create the final stereo file. So that's it for this updated version of our Reaper tutorial, showing you how to record a voiceover with some music behind it, and then how to record some music using a virtual instrument, and then sing along with it to create a vocal track. Come and visit us at Homebrew Audio for tons of free articles on audio recording, and our course, The Newbie's Guide to Audio Recording Awesomeness, showing you how to use Audacity and/or Reaper.